You can also determine and graph equations in slope-intercept form even when you are given limited information. For example, if you are given the slope m and any point x, y, then by substituting the point into the equation, the slope-intercept form equation, for x and y, we can then solve for b. And then you can write the equation of a line when given the slope and a point that the line passes through. Or, if you are given any two points, it's always possible to determine the slope m, you can use the slope formula. So by then substituting one of those points in for x and y, you can solve for b. Then you can write the equation of a line from two points. So let's clarify the steps required by doing some examples for both cases. So in this first example, we're told to write the equation of a line in slope-intercept form that has a slope of 9 and passes through the point 4, 11. So we already know that the slope is 9, or m equals 9. So we also know that a point on the line passes through, that the line passes through is 4, 11, so that can represent the x and y respectively. So by substituting these numbers into our equation, y equals mx plus b, our slope-intercept form equation, it gives us 11 equals 9 times 4 plus b. We can then take that equation and solve for b. So we would first multiply 9 times 4 and get 36, and then we would subtract 36 from both sides of the equation to get that negative 25 equals b. So we know b equals negative 25. So using the slope of 9 and now the newly found y-intercept value of negative 25, our equation y equals mx plus b becomes y equals 9x minus 25. Now, this problem can also be solved using point slope and using the rules of algebra to get it into slope-intercept form. If we have our point 4, 11 as now not just xy but as x1 and y1 and our slope of 9, if we substitute the numbers into point slope, if that form, remember point slope is y minus y1 equals m times the quantity of x minus x1. That gives us y minus 11 equals 9 times the quantity of x minus 4. If we distribute the 9 to the x and the negative 4, that gives us 9x minus 36. And then if we're solving for y, we would add 11 to both sides and we get y equals 9x minus 25. We get that same equation we got before, but instead this time we used point slope instead of directly going to slope intercept form. So here's another example. Here we have, write the equation of a line in slope-intercept form that has a slope of negative 4/5 and passes through the point negative 5, 1. So that first method is to use the slope-intercept form equation. We need what is the slope and what numbers would represent the general point of x, y. Well, we know the slope is negative 4/5, that's what we're told, in the directions, and the point in the directions negative 5, 1 becomes the values for x and y. So we can substitute the numbers into the slope-intercept form equation, y equals mx plus b, and we can solve for that unknown b, that y-intercept. So if we make the substitutions, we get 1 equals negative 4/5 times negative 5 plus b. We would multiply negative 4/5 times negative 5 to get 4. And then subtracting 4 from both sides, we get b equals negative 3. So our equation in slope-intercept form that has a slope of negative 4/5 and passes through the point negative 5, 1 is y equals negative 4/5 x minus 3. And that was using the first method where we used the slope-intercept form equation directly. But remember, the second method allows us to solve for that slope-intercept form from point slope form. So first, if we're using that method, we need to still know what is the slope, but now we don't want to know numbers that represent a general x and y. We want what numbers are going to represent the ordered pair of x1 and y1. Well, we can still use that same slope of negative 4/5, and we can still use the given point of negative 5, 1, but that's representing the x1 and y1 in point slope form. Remember, point slope form, that equation is y minus y1 equals m times the quantity of x minus x1. And if we make those substitutions, then we can solve for y. So that substitution gives us y minus 1 equals negative 4 fifths times x minus negative 5. If we clean up that minus and negative, it gives us x plus 5. We can then distribute the negative 4 fifths to the x and the 5 to give us y minus 1 equals negative 4 fifths x minus 4. And if we add 1 to both sides of the equation, we get y equals negative 4 fifths x minus 3. It's that same slope-intercept form equation we got before. It's just now we used point slope to get there as a kind of middle step. But either way, we were given a point that the line passed through, and we were given the slope of the line, so we had to solve for the y-intercept one way or the other. Now here with example 3, we can see that they're asking us to write the equation of a line in slope-intercept form that passes through the points 6, 0, and 2, 3. So this time we do not know the slope, so we need to calculate it first using the slope formula. So we can think of 6, 0, that point, as our values for x1 and y1, and 8, 1 as our values for x2 and y2. So using the slope formula, remember that's y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. We get 1 minus 0 over 8 minus 6, which gives us a slope of 1 half. So now that we have the slope, we also know that a point that the line passes through is 6, 0 from one of the two given points, and that can represent x and y respectfully. So by substituting these numbers into the slope-intercept form equation, y equals mx plus b, we can then solve for b using the equation 0 equals 1 half times 6 plus b. To do that, we would first multiply 1 half times 6, which gives us 3, and then we would subtract 3 from both sides of the equation, giving us negative 3 equals b. And if we switch the order, that's our value for b. B equals negative 3, so that's our y-intercept. And using it with our value of m, we can write our equation as y equals 1 half x minus 3. This problem can also be solved using the point-slope formula and using the rules of algebra to get it into slope-intercept form as well. We can select one of the points that we're given as x1 and y1 instead of just x and y, and then we can use the slope that we calculated that was 1 half. So let's use that same point of 6, 0 as our x1 and y1. And if we substitute the numbers into point-slope form, remember point-slope form is y minus y1 equals m times the quantity of x minus x1. We'll get y minus 0 equals 1 half times the quantity of x minus 6. And if we distribute the slope and drop the 0, we end up with y equals 1 half x minus 3. We end up with that same slope-intercept form equation. It's just we used point-slope as a middle step to get there. So either way is fine. You don't have to do both ways when solving the problem. It's just which do you prefer working with, going straight to slope-intercept form, solving for b, or going to point-slope and then converting to slope-intercept. Let's do this type of problem one more time where we're given two points and we have to write the equation of the line in slope-intercept form. The two points we're given are negative 1, 8 and 4, 1. So the first thing we can do is ask, what is the slope, right? If we're going to slope-intercept form, no matter what method we use, we need to find the slope using that slope formula. And then first, let's use and go straight to slope-intercept form. We can see what numbers would represent x and y, and then substitute the numbers into the slope-intercept form equation to solve for b. Well, the slope, if we think of negative 8, 1 as x1 and y1, and 4, 1 as x2 and y2, would give us 1 minus 8 over negative 1 minus 4, which is negative 7 over negative 5, which simplifies to a slope of 7 over 5. So if we then use, I'm going to use the second point this time because again, it doesn't matter which point you use, but here I'm using the point 4, 1 as x and y values. So if we substitute now m equals 7 over 5, x equals 4 and y equals 1 into our slope intercept form equation, y equals mx plus b, we get 1 equals 7 over 5 times 4 plus b. And we can solve for b. We multiply 7 over 5 times 4 is 5.6. And then subtracting 5.6 from both sides, we get that b equals negative 4.6. So our final equation and our answer would be y equals 7 over 5x minus 4.6. Now again, the second way of solving the same exact problem is to use the point slope equation, substituting in the slope and now numbers for x1 and y1 into the equation and then solving for y. The slope is going to be exactly the same using that formula. We still get 7 over 5 because we're still using the same two original points. And we can use that same point of 4, 1 to represent x1 and y1. So substituting those into our equation of y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1, we get y minus 1 equals 7 fifths times the quantity of x minus 4. We can then distribute 7 over 5 to both x minus 4. And then if we add 1, we end up getting the equation y equals 7 over 5x minus 4.6, which is what we got before. So this is just showing you that alternate method to answer the question. No matter what, whether you're given 2 points or a point in a slope, the idea is that using point slope or using slope intercept form, the equation itself, you can actually write the equation in slope intercept form no matter what.